Can you walk me through what happened inside of that pharmacy just now? What do they sell?
What don't they sell at this pharmacy? Drug-wise, they sell everything besides crack, cocaine, ecstasy, and Molly, and LSD, I guess. But, like, all the, like, drugs, like cocaine, heroin, methamphetamine, weed, Xanax, like, it, Adderall, ketamine. Yeah, it's like a Disneyland for drugs.
Medical tourism to Mexico from the U.S. is huge, with an estimated 3 million inbound medical travelers in 2020. Medication is cheaper in Mexico, and you can buy most drugs without a prescription. While most people are able to find the care they desperately need, some are also buying cheap, unregulated meds without knowing they're fake. The ingredients can be completely unknown, and in recent years, the DEA have seized counterfeit medication laced with the deadly opioid, fentanyl. It's estimated that 8 million people consume illicit medication in Mexico every year. I want to explore this black market industry, meet the dealers, the people combating this medical crime, and the people risking their lives for their own health.
My father is a pharmacist. He works in a very highly regulated environment where, you know, you have to have a prescription, you have to go to a doctor to get your medicine. But then with my friends, they come to Mexico and they don't have to come with a prescription. They don't have to potentially even see a doctor. They just go to one of the pharmacies and just ask for the medication they're looking for and they get it. So it's as quick as that. So as much as it's simple and easy, it also makes me wonder how dangerous that can be.
I'm heading near the U.S.-Mexico border to Zona Norte, a red light area of Tijuana, where medical tourists often travel to pick up cheaper meds. There I'm meeting with a former opioid user who has regularly traveled to pharmacies on the border for around 10 years to buy Percocet without a prescription after he got hooked on opioids in the U.S. He wishes to remain anonymous and is going to secret film inside of one of these pharmacies, pick up some of the Percocet, and then I'm going to test them to find out what's really in them.
What's up?
What's up, man? How you doing, G?
Doing good.
Cool. Yeah, man. Can I just get two Perc 30s? The two Percocet 30s milligrams?
Yeah.
Okay. That's gonna be money.
I
think
I'm on.
How did you get into Percocet?
A year or two ago, like, I remember trying to buy some heroin and somebody gave me like a blue pill. And this is way better, you know, it's Perc 30s or whatever. I do heroin, that's not gonna touch me. Because I was just like, Perc 30, like, Oxycontin 80s, it's Perc 80s, that's what they probably called it. So I was like, this ain't gonna touch me, bro. But he's like, no, take it for free, trust me. And feel like, well, long story short, I took a hit. And it fucking laid me out. And I already had a tolerance to opiates. You know, I'm like, what the fuck is that? That's not a real Vicodin or Percocet, whatever. I was like, that shit ain't real, bro. I was like, I do now, and that shit put me on my ass.
Do you know anyone who's died from consuming these pills?
I do. Yeah. A close friend of mine had a tolerance to it. Ended up taking a full Percocet and took his life.
Do you have any idea of what might be in them?
I have no idea.
So how would you feel if I told you we were going to test it?
Yeah,
you're cool with that?
Yeah, I want to know.
You want to know?
Yeah.
I'm going to use a portable spectrometer intended for Border Patrol to test if the drugs are counterfeit.
All right, this is going to be a little tricky. I must look so shady right now. No, I think I've grounded it enough. Arm laser. Fentanyl. It says CASNA, illicit drug, and a red label pops up.
A Percocet pill is meant to have oxycodone as its active ingredient. This fake pill is instead cut with a deadly mix of fentanyl and methamphetamine. Fentanyl is 50 times more potent than heroin, and the overdose rate in the U.S. is climbing with the introduction of this illicit opioid, It's estimated that there were 90,000 drug overdoses in the U.S. in 2020. According to the DEA, while Chinese fentanyl seizures are down, the new source of fentanyl are Mexican cartels, specifically the Sinaloa and the Jalisco New Generation cartels, who are essentially criminal armies that rule with impunity.
We're headed to Tepito, one of the largest black markets in Mexico City, where you can find counterfeit medication, makeup, clothes, anything you can think of.
I'm meeting with a local boxing legend called Jorge, who's going to be my guide for Tepito.
Aquí es Tepito.
That's a pharmacy.
Sí, sí.
It has all kinds of medicine, no?
Sí.
It's like for back pain, children's medication. There's
parches para los dolores. Ah, vamos a caminarle también.
Okay, let's go. Yeah, we need to move fast. I could tell that it's sort of risky to stop by there. And then I also noticed a motorbike passed by us, and I hear that the people who are on the motorbikes are often from the cartel. So that's also making me a bit nervous.
Sí, mira, ya hasta aquí podemos llegar ya, pero ya de aquí para allá hay muchas, hay mal horas, ¿sí?
¿Aquí?
Ya es tarde.
It's getting a bit hot, as we suspect cartels or gang spotters have noticed us filming. Jorge insists that we leave, but I still want to speak to a low-level vendor at this market to find out what they're selling and who supplies them.
Por ejemplo, si tú te lo tomas y no sabes qué efecto te vaya a hacer, te va a causar algún daño, no sabemos qué contenga. Eso para, pues, se tiene que llevar a analizar. Para en realidad no sabes qué, no sé si sea veneno para rata. Esto se le llama clonal.
¿Es legal?
Es diferente color de la caja original. Y esto está mal hecho. El color cambia.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And what is the most popular medication? What are people buying from you?
Lo que más busca la gente es para el dolor y antibióticos.
So do you think that the cartels are involved in this?
No lo sé.
Are you scared to tell me about the cartel?
No lo sé. Pues ya como que ya me estoy incomodando.
Our time is up with the black market pharmacist, who's starting to feel uneasy. He seemed genuinely scared when I asked him about the cartel's involvement in the counterfeit medication market, and understandably so. I've set up a meeting with another dealer further up the supply chain. He wants us to meet him at the parking lot of an empty elementary school.
Can you show me the medicine?
Sí, es pirata. Es manejo dos, el básico y el premium. Pirata básico y premium. El pirata normalmente se nota en la caja y el original pues es igualito hasta en los sellos y hologramas. O sea, las pastillas, los comprimidos, todo viene igualito. A menos de que lo pruebes, te das cuenta que es original y que es falso.
I'm looking at it and it does look like legitimate packaging. I wouldn't think that any of this is fake. It looks real. Who are your top clients? Like, what kind of medication are they going for? Or do you even know?
Sí, se vende, o sea, cuando llegan allá a la bodega, los clientes normalmente se lo vendemos a personas de tianguis, farmacias, tienditas.
So you have legal pharmacies purchasing from you in addition to regular bodegas. It's mixed.
Sí, así es. Hay farmacias que te lo compran. Y es donde dicen, ¿no? O sea, al final mucha gente va y compra, oye, pues ¿por qué allá me lo están dejando 10 pesos más barato? Pues ahí tienes tu respuesta. Es porque normalmente meten el medicamento clonado y pues no se dan cuenta.
My takeaway from that interview was, as someone who takes medication for headaches and whatnot, all of that looked pretty legit. But none of it is. All of it's fake.
I need to go even further up the supply chain to find out more about the scale of this operation. Our fixer has managed to track down the manager of a clandestine warehouse.
Ya a mí se me hacía raro que se cayera.
se me hace raro porque como aquí todo, todo controlado, pues todo lo que decide, todo controlado, pues. Tenemos puntero, tenemos todo. Yo no me dejaría agarrar ni mi gente se quedó la policía, no, pero yo me quedo agarrado al lazo. Estando usted aquí, yo no estando, pues.
Sí.
Por seguridad de usted y seguridad de nosotros. Por eso.
Understood. So can you tell me a little bit about the medicine that's here? What is this?
Sí, ¿me entiendes? Son puras pastillitas que te hacen, que a veces que te hacen mal a la gente, son puros venenos, a veces lo hacen con droga. Son cosas fuertes, ¿sí? Ahí está mi nombre.
Yeah, and I also see antidepressants, antibiotics, antidepressants. Are those your most popular ones?
Sí, pues una de esas ya van de salida. Así ya están pedidas ya. Así donde venderlas, a farmacias, a otra gente.
How much does this cost?
Es que en los precios como todo, varían los precios, ¿no? Varían, pero siempre lo que está más, supuestamente más malo son los que más menos valen. Pues. Lo que pega más fuerte son los que más valen. Pero realmente la gente no sabe ni lo que compran, pues sí, entiendo eso. Son originales, pero pues realmente lo que viene por dentro no es original.
Can you tell me how much you sell in dollars?
En millones, así es. Muchos millones.
Are you associated with the cartels in any way?
Yo ahí ya sería ese el patrón, yo ahí ya no me meto. Yo no hago mi trabajo y ya de ahí para allá.
So where else are these fake drugs being distributed to? Not only are makeshift pharmacies selling illegal prescription drugs in Mexico, this is also happening in the US. I'm in Alvarado Street in LA, where we have reason to believe there are street vendors selling potentially counterfeit meds. I'm going to secret film, pick some up, and get them tested.
In the beginning, we started off very easy. We just asked for medication related to pain. But the crazy thing is just walking through that street, there were all kinds of medication being openly sold there. And the packaging were, some look fake. It didn't look like the authentic thing, like Advil PM, Tylenol PM.
Oh, sí tiene, mira. Es que hemos estado buscando, pero ¿tienes algo para dormir fuerte?
I asked about Xanax, if they had Xanax, and she said they did. And she gave me this bar, Xanax bar. The funny thing is there's no label on it. This was something she said I should only take half of one because it's so strong and will knock me out immediately. Then she gave me diazepam, which is more benzos, and said the same thing. These have labels on them, but they're different labels. Some say DZ and others say M. The Xanax bar she showed us, she said, this is from Mexico, this is from Mexico. She kept saying that over and over again. This is from Mexico and this is really, really strong. It's from Mexico and it's strong. Are you sure you want this? And we paid $5 for one bar.
Now I need to get these tested to find out if they're fake or legit. I'm meeting with Adam Hopkins from Metrum, a leading manufacturer of high precision instruments for chemical analysis.
This is the 10 milligram Xanax, mm-hmm. Right? So that's the Xanax that should be very, very powerful. So we put this Xanax tablet in here, arm and acquire. We're just gonna see what this does. Wow, all right. You don't need much, I mean, 10 milligrams, that's crazy.
Why?
Because you should never have a Xanax pill with enough Xanax for the instrument to detect it right off the bat. It's like, that's a lot of Xanax. Frankly, any of these things that are not licensed to be sold in the US on the street, that's a little scary to me.
The black market exists because of the overpriced healthcare system in the US. In 2019, over 26 million people were without health insurance, and even people with coverage in the US chose to receive care in Mexico because it's much cheaper. Now with criminals not just distributing fake medication to markets, but to real pharmacies in Mexico, who are the people willing to cross the border from the US for cheaper everyday healthcare, knowing that their medication could be counterfeit?
We're about to meet with a woman called Lupita, whose son-in-law operates within the pharmaceutical industry in Tijuana. He knows people, he goes to the pharmacies there, and he also helps his mother-in-law get medication as well. Hola.
Hola. Hola, ¿cómo está?
¿Cómo estás?
I want to ask Lupita why she chooses to get medical treatment across the border. and what she feels about recent reports of 14 patients dying and 50 falling ill in Pemex Regional Hospital in Tabasco, Mexico, from being administered counterfeit medication by a doctor.
Pues la verdad, Estados Unidos me da miedo. Lo que les importa es el dinero, no les importa la salud de la persona.
There have been several people recently that have died from counterfeit drugs in Mexican hospitals. What are your thoughts on that? Does that concern you?
Sí me asusta porque yo tengo una experiencia también que me compro un medicamento para la tos, me anestesió la garganta y ya no podía yo respirar. Me iba yo a morir.
It's estimated there were as many as 3 million inbound medical travelers to Mexico as of February 2020, and recent reports note a strong resurgence in medical tourism in the past few months to nearly 100% in border towns, including Tijuana. I want to ask Lupita's son-in-law, Jim, why he also chooses to buy medication across the border.
It's so expensive.
Huh?
It's a little bit expensive.
It's expensive here?
It depends.
So it's more expensive than the States, or?
No. Not more expensive.
Cheaper than the States.
Cheaper than the States. Just different pharmacies here will have like different prices, stuff like that.
Got you.
Yeah.
So what'd you end up getting?
So I have sumatriptan. It's a migraine medication. It's non-narcotic, but in the United States, you need a prescription for it. In the United States, the copay would be about $150 just to visit the doctor, plus a $95 copay on the medication. So it adds up, definitely. It's a lot easier just to walk in and pay $60, or actually that was more like $45. I think my conversion's a little off.
That's significantly cheaper than...
Significantly.
Than the U.S.
Yeah, than the U.S. And that's with having insurance in the U.S. That's a $95 copay.
But how do you know this is the real deal? I mean...
I don't. So
no.
I take it and it's effective. That's how I know that it's the real deal.
Okay, so you feel it.
I feel it.
But don't you ever wonder or worry whether it's fake or not?
It's in the back of my mind, for sure, initially. But I've never had a bad experience so far. So the benefits outweigh the risk for me, I would say.
The majority of healthcare in Mexico is a lifeline for people. But from what I've seen, there's a shift in the black market from lifestyle drugs to what are meant to be life-saving drugs by cartels and independent criminals who are exploiting the demand for medication by victims of the overpriced healthcare system in the U.S. The most shocking element of this is the move by criminals to synthesize the effects of powerful pain medication, in turn exacerbating the opioid crisis. Mostly what I've seen highlights the greater sickness of the inability of our medical system to deliver care in a cost-effective way across a broad spectrum of society.